नमस्ते, आई JVN ज्योति कुमावत, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोलॉजी, गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर ऑन ग्लोबल वार्मिंग दैट इज़ बिलोंग टू सब्जेक्ट एनवायरमेंटल साइंस एंड द डिसिप्लिन इज BSc BEd BA BEd सेकेंड सेमेस्टर. सो फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द डेफिनेशन व्हाट इज़ ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. ग्लोबल वार्मिंग एक्चुअली इज़ अ ग्रेजुअल इंक्रीज इन द अर्थ टेम्परेचर generally due to greenhouse effect caused by increased level of carbon dioxide, CFC and other pollutants. In other words, we also explain the global warming is the phenomena of gradual increase in temperature near the earth surface. This phenomena has been observed over the past one or two centuries. This change has disturbed the climate pattern of the earth. However, the concept of global warming is quite controversial, but the scientists have provided relevant data in support of the fact that the temperature of earth is rising constantly. Now we talk about the causes of global warming. What are the main causes? There are several causes of global warming which have negative effect on human, plant and animal lives. These causes may be natural or might be the outcome of human activities. In order to curb the issues, it is very important to understand the negativity of global warming. Let us have a detailed study of global warming, its causes and its effect. Now, causes of global warming. First causes, man-made causes of global warming. First, deforestation. Plants are the main sources of oxygen. They take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen, thereby maintaining environmental balance. The forests are being depleted of many domestic and commercial purpose. This has to lead to an environmental imbalance, thereby giving rise to global warming. If we talk the second causes, the second cause is your use of vehicle, the high quantity. The use of vehicle even for every short distances result into various gaseous emission. Vehicle burn fossil fuel which emit a large amount of carbon dioxide and other toxins into the atmosphere, resulting in a temperature increase. Third reason is chlorofluorocarbon. With the excessive use of air conditioner and refrigerator, humans have been adding CFCs into the environment, which affect the atmospheric ozone layer. The ozone layer protects the earth's surface from the harmful ultraviolet rays emitted by the sun. And the CFC has led to ozone layer depletion, making way for the ultraviolet rays, thereby increasing the temperature of the earth. Next reason come to the industrial development. In 2013, the Intergovernmental Panel for the Climate Change reported that the increase in the global temperature between 1880 and 2012 has been 0.9 degrees Celsius. And the increasing is 1.1 degree Celsius when compared to the pre-industrial mean temperature. With the advent of industrialization, the temperature of the earth has been increasing rapidly. The harmful emission from the factories added to the increasing temperature of the earth. Next causes is agriculture. Various farming activities produce carbon dioxide and methane gases. These add to greenhouse gases in the atmosphere and increase the temperature of the earth. Next cause come to the overpopulation. This is the big result, big cause you can say for the global warming. Increasing in population mean more people breathing. This lead to an increase in the level of carbon dioxide. The primary gas causes global warming in the atmosphere. Now these was the man-made now we talk about the some natural causes of global warming. As you can see, also have listened about the volcanoes. Volcanoes are one of the large natural contributors to global warming. The ash and the smoke emitted during volcanic eruption goes out into the atmosphere and affects the climate. Second natural causes is your water vapor. Water vapor is a kind of greenhouse gas due to the increase in Earth's temperature. More water gets evaporated from the water bodies and stay in the atmosphere, adding to a global warming. Next, natural is melting permafrost. Permafrost is the way there where glaciers are present. It is frozen soil actually that has environmental gases trapped it for several years. As the permafrost melt, it release the gases back into the atmosphere, increasing the earth temperature. Next causes is forest blazes. Forest blazes or forest fire, we can also say, emit a large amount of carbon containing smoke. These gases are released into the atmosphere and increase the earth's temperature, resulting in global warming. Now these were the causes. Now we talk about some effects of global warming. The following are the some effects. First, rising in temperature. Global warming has led to an incredible increase in Earth's temperature. Since 1880s, the Earth temperature has increased by 1.4 degree. This has resulted in an increase in melting of glacier, which have led to an increase in the sea level. This could have devastating effects of coastal region. Second effect you can observe as a threat to the ecosystem. Global warming has affected the coral reefs that can lead to a loss of plant and animal lives. Increase in global temperature has made the fragility of coral reef even worse. So third is your climate change. Global warming has led to a change in climate condition also. There are droughts at some places and flood at some. This climate imbalance the result of our global warming. Next effect we observe as a spread of disease. Global warming lead to a change in the pattern of heat and humidity. This has led to the movement of mosquitoes that carry and spread diseases. Decrease in the human population due to the decrease in flood, tsunami and other natural calamities, the population of human tend to decrease. Also the spread of disease led to a decrease in the human population. Next this effect is loss of natural habitat. A global shift in the climate leads to the loss of habitat of several plants and animals. In this case, the animal need to migrate from the natural habitat to many of them even get extinct. This is yet another major impact of global warming on biodiversity. Now these were the effects. Now come to the point that what should be solution for the global warming. So some are here, some solutions you can observe. One, as a renewable energies, the first way to prevent climate change is to move away from fossil fuel. What are the alternatives? Renewable energies like solar, wind, biomass and geothermal. Second, energy and water efficiency. Producing clean energy is essential, but reducing our consumption of energy and water by using more efficient devices, example LED, light bulb, innovative shower system, is less costly and equally. In next solution, you can say observe the sustainable transportation, promoting public transport and carpooling, but also electric and hydrogen mobility can definitely help reduce carbon dioxide emission and thus fight global warming. Next point comes as a sustainable infrastructure. In order to reduce the carbon dioxide emission from building caused by heating, air conditioning, hot water or lighting, it is necessary both to build new low energy building and to renovate the existing constructions. Next, sustainable agriculture and forest management. Encouraging better use of natural resources, stopping massive deforestation, as well as making agriculture greener and more efficient should also be a priority. The last solution we can observe is the responsible consumption and recycling. Adopting responsible consumption habits is crucial, be it regarding food, particularly meat, clothing, cosmetics or cleaning products. Last but not least, recycling is an absolute necessity for dealing with waste. I hope you understand all the lecture about I discussed today, the global warming. Thank you.